Hello, my name's Pete, aka Houseborn from Houseborn's World, and today is the day that I'm going to start putting the Ryzen build together. I'm way overdue an upgrade. The PC you can see in front of you is the Corsair Obsidian 450D mid tower case, and inside I'm currently running a Phenom 2 quad core 965 black edition. Start getting all the bits out so the case is bare, so I can start planning how I'm going to put in all the new components. Just looking at the front of the case now, but you can see the Blu-ray drive on the top panel. You've got your headphone microphone input, reset button, and two USB 3 ports. Down the bottom you've got the current 120mm Corsair fan, and just above that you won't see is the radiator for the R9 Fury X. So I've got the fan pulling in and the radiator from the Fury X pushing out. When I change over to the Ryzen build, I may change the configuration of that. On the top of the case you've got like a magnetic mesh that fits on, we'll look at that shortly. And that allows air to vent in or out. I'm currently blowing air out. I'm currently pushing air out at the moment out the case, but we might change that configuration. So I'm just going to swap the case around. So the side view, nothing exciting to talk about there. Let's move on to the back. On the back of the case you can see the slots for the expansion cards on the motherboard. We've also got some open mesh grill for cooling, and you can see the power supply vents directly out the back of the case. And also in the top of the case we've got a 120mm fan for extraction. Again, I may change how I do that. And now we move on to the window view. Quite like this because when I get the new board in, especially with the lighting on the Corsair Hero 6 board, the LED lit RAM, the graphics card and the Kraken cooler should give my system quite the vajazzle it's needed. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to go ahead, we'll take the sides of the case off, then I'm going to lay the case down on the floor and we'll start taking the components out. Because I'm going to reuse this motherboard in another build, is all I'm going to do at the moment is disconnect the graphics card and the water pump, and then I'll unplug all the various drives and then just take the board out in one go. So it's quite easy to take the screws out the back of this. There's only two thumb screws and it's best not to drop them on the back of your case. And the side panel pops off. I'm just going to pop that over there. Right, just spinning the case round, you can see the other side, the blank side of the case, again dropping the thumb screws off. Now what I'm going to do is just slide this off. Unfortunately this is the messy side of the case, but it's quite cool because you can store all the inside the cables that you don't want to see, and as you can see there it's also storage for two solid state drives. So I've got the Samsung 950 Pro and a Crucial M500. Now, something I would say to think about before you start dismantling your PC and going ahead and knocking a new build up: have you backed everything up? Have you deactivated Windows? Because if you've got a retail license and you're installing Windows on your new system that you're using on your old system, one, deactivate it so if you do boot from that drive again it doesn't try and claim the license, and two, probably think ahead that you might have to contact Microsoft. If you've got an OEM license, if you're very, very lucky in exceptional circumstances, you might be able to use it again. Generally, if it's an OEM license, it's licensed to the machine the PC built was on, and it's not going to transfer to a new machine. So now I've got the sides off, I'm going to start disconnecting. Just finally got everything stripped out of the case. The only thing I've got in there at the moment is the power supply and the hard drive bay enclosure. I highly recommend that you use a magnetic screwdriver. And whenever you're working on a PC, fitting motherboard, graphics card, any components, do not use power tools. Use standard screwdriver, magnetic screwdriver. I wasn't going to film me taking it to bits because all you're hearing is me swearing and cursing as I drop screws and lose them temporarily. But right, now the case is empty, I'm just going to start weighing up the components, see how everything fits. I've took out of the very top of the case the top fan, and I'm going to get the cracking in a minute and marry it up and see how that goes. So when we come back, I should have cleaned the case as well, so it's a bit dusty inside, so I'm going to give it a quick blast with the air duster, and we'll catch up in a second. Just for the people that asked for it, I will do some unboxing, as some people seem to like that. So what I'm going to do, I'll open the cracking up, product manual there, guide. If I open the box here, alright. There we go. Let's get off onto one side. Okay, so we're in the box. I'll turn it around that way. We've got the fans. I should put them over there. Other fan. If you can actually get it out, there you go. Fittings that don't actually fit. I've actually got the AM4 bracket that was sent to me from America, but I will need these retaining screws there. Screw onto the pull up, trap that down there. And then various cables. Come back down. They're going to be needed to power the system, USB cable to control the settings on the system. Although we've got the actual cooler in itself, they've packed really well. They do try and look after you at NZXT. I'll get that out of the way. And there we go. Where is the big radiator? So what I've got to do, try and work out how I'm going to get that into the case. Now it's not going to foul on all the other stuff. And here's the actual pump. I'm not going to take that out for a minute. We'll also be removing the thermal paste off this because I don't want to use that. I've got some better paste for that. So while I go and have a working out how this is going to fit, I'll see you in a second. Hi guys, so I'm back. So at the moment, the case is completely dismantled, as you can see over there. And I've just blitzed the living room floor with all the bits. Trying to marry the radiator up into the top of the case is a very, very, very tight fit. Because I want to keep the Blu-ray drive enclosure, I'm not 100% sure if it's going to fit with the motherboard in. So what I've done, I've taken the hard drive bay enclosure out, and the radiator will go in the front of the case absolutely easy. So what I wanted to do, just very quickly, I'll pan the camera back down, because people wanted to see unboxing, not really one of my big things, but I'll do it for the people who want to see it. I'm actually going to get the motherboard out, fit the motherboard into the case, and then I'll know exactly what can go where. At the moment, with the case I've got, I'm thinking what I'm going to be doing is pulling air through the front of the case, through the radiator for the crack and cooler. I'm going to put 320mm fans in the top of the case, bringing air into the case. And I'm going to have the water pump on the Fury X as an exhaust out of the case. So, let's get the Corsair Crosshair Hero 6 box open. If I pull that slightly closer, there are plastic protective case over the top of it, and there is the motherboard. I'm just going to actually have to swing to the side to take the board out. Now, I'm guessing I do that. Has the board actually just come out? No. There we go. The board actually comes straight out, and there is the motherboard. So I'm gonna go and get this lined up in the case and get it screwed in. What I will do, hold that there. I'll put this bit of plastic here. Drop that on there. I can show you what else is inside here. I'm guessing that just comes out. So, also in the box, that's some little stickers. The probably driver disc. What I would say is, although it's still a new motherboard, don't bother with a disc. Go onto the website, download the latest BIOS and drivers like I've already done. Okay, so I want that. That gives me a coupon code for cables. I might actually have to edit that bit out. Little diagram. The manual. Little coaster, and underneath here should be my cables. So I've got two SATA cables, not sure what that's for at the moment. I'll work that out. And on this side we've got the back plate, the mounting kit for the M2, and the little power connector for all the ground front chassis buttons. And we also have an SLI bridge, and I think that's also for the M2 as well. Sorry, not looking at the actual camera. There you go, that's the unboxing of the motherboard. Just wanted to add, right in the bottom of the box, so I didn't realise was a box of, sheet of stickers. So as you can see there, some nice little stickers from the ROG sticker collection. Nice one. So I've just fitted the motherboard into the case. And to be honest, it wasn't as straightforward as I thought. Although the build quality of the board's probably the best motherboard I've ever had, the back plate is quite padded and shielded. And what I found is, I was sure I pushed it in firmly enough, but when I tried to put the board in, it was springing the board back out. So what I did, I had to take the board out, make sure I'd really gone to town on pushing it in. And the second time putting it in, it was a little easier, and you have to almost force the board against the springiness of the back plate that goes on the back of the motherboard for where the fittings clip in. And with just a little bit of pressure, I managed to get all the screws in. So what I'm going to do next is get the two heatsink retaining clips off, because I've got to put the AM4 retaining screws in for the Kraken, and then we'll go from there. Hey guys, just another little catch up for where we're at. So while the video was paused, what I've done, I've got the motherboard in, the processor is now in, as you can see I've got the RAM in, I've also put in the M2 SSD, and if you look to your right hand side, the 240mm RAD's in. I've put the AM4 retaining bracket on, and if I just come into over here, I removed the standard retaining clips, and you can see there I've put the retaining bolts in. Okay, it's pretty late. I'm hanging, and I got to work in the morning, so I'm going to pick this up tomorrow. So what really we've got to start doing I've got to get the thermal compound off there, put some of the thermal grizzly on there I've got. We've got to, well, I should put the compound on the processor, get that connected up. I've got to get the Blu-ray drive back in, and then it's going to be wiring. Pretty much ready to go. The only caveat that I've had so far, I've had to take my storage out, so I'm going to have to come up with another solution for that. Oh, and also I've got to fit the fans into the top of the case. The radiator would not fit. Well, it would fit in the top of the case, but it was that tight against the motherboard. I decided against it. I mean, I don't know if you can see there. I don't know if you can see that. I slightly nicked the top of the board, which is a shame. I'll have to try and polish that out with the radiator. So, to be honest, it fits perfectly in the front. So I'm quite happy with that. Okay, right, I'm off to bed. And we'll pick this up tomorrow night. Hey everyone, I'm back again and it's the build day two. So not a lot more has happened at the minute. Before I went to bed last night, I got the Fury card in. I decided, I may have already said this yesterday, sorry, it's been a long day, that I'm going to mount the radiator for the Fury as an exhaust out onto the back fan extraction there. That's where I'm tapping. I've also, last night, I put the 220mm fans in the top of the case. They're going to draw air inwards. Now, the reason at the moment I've not got that much further, and I just thought I'd mention this if it saves anyone any time, I've just wasted probably an hour and a half trying to find the connections bag for my power supply. Because on the Corsair Hero 6, you've got the 24-pin plug, you've got an 8-pin plug and an additional 4-pin plug. Now, having a blonde moment, not really thinking about it, I thought, oh yeah, I'll go and find the bag for the power supply connections, get the 4-pin plug as well. Now, if I'd actually stopped and thought about it, my power supply doesn't have a 4-pin plug. So I panicked stations, oh my god, well, do I need both power? So I looked in the motherboard manual and they recommend you must have the 8-pin. And if you want additional power, use the 4-pin. So do I need the 4-pin? Well, I've been online, I've read a few posts, and from what it seems, the 4-pin's only there as an extra boost if you're doing extreme overclocking. With you don't need both. I should be able to run fine with the 8-pin plug. So I'm going to blast on with the wiring. In a minute we'll come back and we'll clean the thermal compound off the head of the cooler for the NZXT, and hopefully in a minute we'll get somewhere near done and we'll start getting windows to, well, start getting it fired up. I don't know if the thing works yet, so see you back soon. So I got some thermal compound remover, and what I'm going to do, get that off the heatsink of the Kraken cooler. I'll bang this over, let's just get it on there. There you go. Actually, what a job that's doing. That's coming straight off. I'll try not to get it on the edge. I'll show you back on the camera there. It's looking quite good. Quite silvery, actually, that stuff. I'll put a bit more on. Give that another rub. We want to get this as clean as we possibly can. There we go. Don't want to leave any imperfections. What I'm going to do, I'm going to get another piece of kitchen towel. Kitchen towel's probably not the best thing to use, it can be abrasive. Right, I'm just gonna go and get another piece. Just before. Okay, so this is a clean piece. Once again, I'm just gonna rub that round. Just make sure we got that absolutely spotlessly clean. And as you can see, by the kitchen towel, where you can see some of the marks there. Let's try a bit more. Right, now I've done that there, put a bit back on this. Now I've got the surface purifier, and I don't think kitchen towel's probably the best plan for that. I'm going to go and try and find another cloth or something. Something that's not going to leave small bits or marks on it. So I couldn't find a lint-free cloth, so what I'm going to do... just use the air duster and that gets rid of any bits that could have been on there. So this time I'm going to clean the CPU. So I've got my thermal surface purifier. I know kitchen towel's not the best thing in the world. It's all that's around for me at the minute. I'm just going to very gently put this on. Just going to let that dry, and then actually once it's dry I'll blast it with the air duster. You can actually see that evaporating off the chip as we talk. I'm then going to mount the heatsink and the pump head onto the processor. I just gave that a quick blast with the air duster. I didn't spray it directly on the processor, just around it. So now I'm sure both surfaces are clean. I'm going to pop some, you can see it there, thermal grizzly, Hydronaut. Now, you don't really need thermal grease like this. Any Arctic Silver or anything will do, but this is meant to be really, really good. And as I wanted to... put the effort in on the Ryzen system, I thought I'd go ahead and try it. Now there's many methods of putting thermal grease onto a processor, and if you look online, I'm pretty sure there'll be many explanations of what you should or shouldn't do. There's the P method, the line method, the cross method, there's actual method of spreading it out over the processor. Now I didn't know, but I've been told and watching videos online, people saying that you can create air pockets. Now personally, I've always spread it with an old like type credit card or plastic card, something like that, across the processor, and I've never ever had a problem in my life. But obviously I wouldn't want to give people bad advice, so what I would say is put it on how you feel. From what I've seen, the cross method's probably the most reliable, so you get the most spread. But we'll see. Just opening this packet, it has got like an applicator to put it on and spread it out. So it is in German. I imagine there'd be some English instructions, which there is, so I'm just going to quickly read that and we'll come back. So after reading the instructions and working out that you unscrew the bottom, it comes with quite a handy little applicator. It's rubber, and they recommend you squeeze a bit out and thin it out, spread a thin layer out. I'm actually going to try it. Why not? You can see that I've some on the end, so I'm just going to try spreading that. And it says to spread it as thin as possible. Now, to be honest, that hasn't given me very much. So if I squeeze some more out, now it's very, very important you do not get this over the edge of the processor or on the motherboard. It's obviously thermal grease conduct electricity. That, I've got to say, is not going how I would expect. I've never worked with thermal grizzly before. I personally have always used Arctic Silver, and that seems quite messy. It's not actually spreading as I would expect. I don't actually like how that's coming out. Frankly, that's quite terrible. I didn't actually clean it off. I changed my mind. I decided that, well, to be honest, I tried to thin it out as much as I could. It's not like the Arctic Silver that I've used before. When I clamp the pump head down, it's going to squash it down anyway. I was a bit close to the edge on parts, but it's only a thin application. At the end of the day, if it's not right, I can always take it off and do it again. As the Hydronaut Thermal Grizzly is quite expensive, sod it. I'm going to just try it as it is. I think it'll be fine. It don't look too bad, but I'm going to give it a go anyway. So, what I'm going to do, get this lined up. Now, my idea is that it's going to go on here, and I'm going to drop these below down by the Fury so you can see the memory. The only problem with that is if I have that in that orientation, the wires are going to be hitting on the memory, so I might actually change how I have that. I really wanted it with the pump pipes at the bottom though. Saying that, I could bend the wires up and go round. I think I'm going to go for this configuration. So, if I line this up and go with them holes. And then what I want the retaining screws. One on one corner, now I'm only going to do these finger tight, and as you're putting them on, it's very careful that you don't cross thread them. Last one on before I start tightening. Now careful, so I'll drop that there. It's not the best thing to do on the board. When you're in tight spots, you gotta expect stuff like this. Again, magnetic screwdriver is always your friend. There we go. Make sure it's not cross-threaded. I'm just going to start evening the pressure up. The top's getting quite tight. I want to go from diagonal to diagonal, and I say I'm only going to do this finger tight. I've got quite some way to do up yet by the look of it. I don't know what it is with this corner, right? I've got this one. Doesn't seem to be tightening as well as the others. There you go, it's got that. Tight. Tight. There we go. So we're only going for finger tight. One's got a bit more to go yet. And that makes sure he's got adequate pressure on the processor. I'm happy with that. That's tight. And we're back again. If I only had a penny for every time I've said that. Okay, so all the wiring just to get the machine up and running is done. What you're seeing at the moment is the rear side of it that you won't see, but I'm just going to tidy all the cables up and then I'll just show you what I've done. And then we'll move to the front of the case and we'll just show, might tidy a few little things up in there. And then we're ready to get Windows going. So see you back in a second.